I love this smell of fresh herbs. And you know what I do when I come to Georgia? The first thing, I just run to the market and I buy all these wonderful fresh herbs. And then I use them in all these delicious Georgian dishes. Kamar djoba! Hello, my friends, and welcome back to Tamada's Table. I am in Georgia and we have new Tamada today. Teymuraz from Kakheti. And together with Tamada, we decided to have conversation with you about the power of fresh herbs. Because fresh herbs are the muscle of Georgian cuisine, and we use a lot of fresh herbs, and we use them in combination. So I think it's worth having this conversation, and you know that it's recommended to have like half pound or 200 grams of fresh herbs every day, because they have wonderful health benefits and nutrients. And so let's start looking at each of the fresh herbs which we use in Georgia. And all these are local fresh herbs which I just got at the market. So let's look at each of them, let's look at the combinations, and let's have this exciting conversation. So let's start looking at each particular herb, and I want to start, of course, with Her Royal Highness. Cilantro is number one fresh herb which we use in almost all dishes, and here is just regular green cilantro, and this is flowering cilantro which we are using to season Georgian condiments and sauces made with fruit and vegetables. Flowering kinzi or cilantro, and you see the flowers on the top of the leaves, and that makes delicious dishes, especially for lobio beans dishes, and we also use it in different sauces, and it has terrific aroma, and we often use it in combination with just cilantro leaves, but this is flowering cilantro. So now let's talk about the basil. In Georgia, actually, we use purple basil, not so much green basil. Although in Western Georgia, of course, they use shashkulavi, which is green basil. Let's say if I make green lobio beans, then I will be using shashkulavi green basil. But mostly we use this wonderful purple basil, which I love and I use in many dishes. And it also has different names in different countries. And sometimes it's known as African basil or Greek basil. And this is the purple basil we use in Georgia. We also eat a lot of fresh herbs, and it's the simple sandwich in Georgia, which we all love. It's tarragon. Here is Georgian tarragon, which is slightly different from French tarragon. And what we do, we usually take a piece of good Georgian bread, like this is shoti puri. So tear it. So these are strings of tarragon. I'll put it on my piece of shoti puri, see? And if I have a pungent cheese like tushin or gouda, these are like really pungent Georgian cheeses, then I will add on top, and this will be my sandwich and my lunch, which is very healthy and also very tasty. But tarragon is also like very favorite fresh herb in Georgia, and we use it in a lot of dishes. So we flavor the meat stews and fish with it. We add the tarragon to the mushrooms, and we even make soda from tarragon, which is a very bright green, beautiful color. Now I want to show you His Majesty kondari or summer savory, because in Georgia, if you make bean dishes, you don't make them without kondari. And all fresh herbs in Georgia, they are seasonal. Kondari is too. And the season for kondari is very short. So this is summer savory kondari in its fresh form. But if you don't have fresh kondari, because after the summer we won't have fresh kondari, I will be using dried ground kondari if I will be making any kind of bean dish. Now, what I want to show you is Georgian celery. And you will ask, why, Tatiana, Georgia, celery is celery, right? No, it's not. Because in Georgia, this is the celery we are using. And here is the parsley. So you see that Georgian celery looks more like parsley. It's not like the celery we use in the US and in some other countries, which has these big stems. Look, This is Georgian celery, and we use it in many dishes, in many stews, and also for pickling. Georgian celery is actually very similar to Chinese celery, so which you can use to substitute. But you know, when I'm in the US, I use just celery, which I can buy in the supermarket, and it does not really mess up with the flavor of the dishes which I make. So next, let's look at ombalo or pennyroyal. And this is very unique fresh herb. Here is ombalo. Georgians make a lot of condiments and sauces. This is ombalo or pennyroyal, and you see that these leaves I will strip from the stems, and I will be using in tkemali plum sauce. And very favorite Georgian plum sauce tkemali, which is made from very sour, unripe plums like that. Look, I will explain to you later, but this is local tkemali, and tkemali is local to Georgia, so it grows only in Georgia. But to make this sauce, of course, I will give you substitutes. So this is pink tkemali, this is red tkemali, and to make tkemali, ombalo would be the fresh herb number one. So you will ask me, oh, Tatiana, I don't have pennyroyal, so my tkemali is not going to be delicious. Well, if you don't have pennyroyal, you can use the mint. And here is my garden mint. I mean, this is available in every country. So if you don't have ombalo, you can use regular garden mint. Now let's look at this wonderful fresh herb. And this is actually called cerezo, but this is fennel. So if you don't have cerezo, which we use also in tkemali plum sauce or in some other condiments and sauces in some other dishes, you can always use just simple dill. So no problems. I'm giving you always substitutes. So let's say I decided to make tkemali plum sauce, and here is my tkemali. So which herbs in combination I would use? And number one would be flowering kinzi or cilantro, see? Because it has flowers on it, so this would be kinzi or cilantro, which I would be using to make the tkemali. And let's put it here. I would also use a little bit of green regular cilantro, and then I would use ombalo, pennyroyal, and then I would use cerezo, which is fennel. So these are my three main fresh herbs for tkemali plum sauce. And if I would be making like bean dish, I told you that I would be using kondari. I will be definitely using kinza, cilantro, and in some dishes I would be using niahuri or celery. In some dishes I would be adding even parsley, and for some dishes I would be adding this purple basil. So look, all this is plenty of fresh herbs which will go in the same pot, and they give this delicious combination of flavors for which Georgian cuisine is so known. So now let's say I want to prepare the famous Georgian tomato and cucumber salad, of which Georgians never get tired. It's kind of like national salad. And you know, you will look at these tomatoes and you will understand why. These are like pink tomatoes of the season, and you know, the skin is bursting with juice, and they are so sweet and tasty that the salad would be delicious. So let's say for tomato and cucumber salad, I would be using fresh herb number one is purple basil. I would add some parsley, and some people like to add cilantro. I don't, so I would be using only these two herbs, but the combination would be excellent for tomatoes and cucumbers and onions, and of course a little bit of garlic and a lot of chilies. And these are chili peppers, red and green, we are using in Georgia. So you can look at them very well, because sometimes, you know, I can't find these varieties in New York. So these are the chili peppers, and they go also into the salad bowl. And you know, the first thing I do when I come to Georgia, I run to the market and I buy plenty of fresh herbs. I should mention they are not expensive in Georgia, so you can really afford to buy plenty of these fresh herbs and use them in combinations in all these delicious Georgian dishes. And Timuras and I, we encourage you to start using the plenty of fresh herbs in your cooking, because now you know how to use them the way the Georgians do. And that's really great health benefit. And also you can experiment, of course, and use your imagination, you know, and create your own combination of these fresh herbs. So just like mess with them a little bit, they like that. If you like this conversation, please let me know through your likes and comments, which are very important to me. Please subscribe. Please share with your family and friends. Come back for my weekly postings. Nachwandis genatswale. Bye for now.